Volkswagen engines to the bartender, and I mean I sat there like I was just a little kid that didn't know anything, because they were discussing Porsche engines and Volkswagen engines and from 1950s to 60s to 70s, and I was just like totally amazed.
Well, I've known Bill for a couple of years. We've done some projects together, and I called him Geo Man. Every time I needed something environmentally, I'd give him a call and we'd talk about it. He would be missed. I would ask him a question about an environmental issue, and I thought it would take 5 minutes. An hour and a half later, we're still talking. And that's just how he was, full of energy. He will be sorely missed.
Well, I just want to say, I think our whole family's going to miss Bill and my girls. We're going to miss them. We have some really great memories of Bill's loud enthusiasm.
He did carry.
He had no filter.
He didn't have a voice.
No filter at all.
He was the best guy. He always wanted to help people. He never wanted to take anything from anybody. You know, he just always wanted to give, all the time. And he was so smart. I mean, I didn't talk to him about all the sciencey kind of stuff, although he'd explain it to me. But, you know, I had a question about how to handle this situation or that situation, and he was always great advice, very caring, thoughtful, an amazing guy.
He was.
He was really a great guy.
Well, I'd say that Bill had a fascination with veterans and with PTSD and with Vietnam War. And every time we talked, no matter whether it was about the environmental situation we were facing, every time we got around to talking about Vietnam. And so he had a genuine interest in all that was for veterans.
Side of Bill. You men here are lots of men who are here who have known him for 20 years. We all got together and taught each other how to love children, women, honor our brothers. But the hardest thing to do is to honor yourself. A lot easier to love someone else than to love yourself. And as much as we try, very few of us learn to do that. We will love him forever. Thank you.
start my first product, and he lent me $10,000 out of just nowhere. And we were good friends the whole time, went to Algeria together, to other places, and he was a close friend of mine, and I loved him dearly. You know, I had no clue that this was happening. I got one of the last calls, I think, because it was sometime on Thursday afternoon. He called me and said, come by and pick up this stuff. I would have called him up because I knew there would be something wrong, because there's no reason for him to ask me to pick that up. I didn't. I didn't hear until Saturday morning. He's one of the best people, person in the world that I've ever met, and I'll miss him.
I met Bill in 1976. UCLA, and I was just a freshman. He was one of the upperclassmen. Something, you know, to respect to my elder. And the two things that were obvious right away was that I think he's one of the smallest guys, pretty sure, on the team. And, you know, they say it's not the size of the dog in the fight, it's the size of the fight in the dog. And Bill was the guy that, Wild Bill, as I heard it.
That's what he was called.
The workouts,
Wild Bill.
Arena, he would, which are very serious, heavy-duty workouts every day, he would ride his bicycle from UCLA to the workout. So what most people consider to be a fairly substantial workout, he did just to get to the workout, and then back home. So that enthusiasm, you know, was stories I'd tell for years about this guy. And that was, of course, many, many years ago, 40 years ago, and a number of years back, I don't know, 5-6 years ago, somehow we had talked at an alumni get together, and Discovery Island lived blocks away from him, and kind of helped him with some projects he had, some imaginative stuff, and he helped me with some things, and let me use his shop for equipment storage, and that same enthusiasm, that same Wild Bill, hadn't diminished in the slightest. And I really, really treasured knowing him. Marvelous man.
Hey, Andy, why don't you say a few words? You were very close to him.
Yeah. He used to call me his little brother. And I met him on the job. He was referred to me. And I showed up in my brand new vest with my boots that had been scuffed up. And he showed me what work was and how it really gets done. And what he really did was he opened the textbook and tore out the table of contents, and he said, I'm going to teach you here. So it was a great adventure I had with him. He was my pillar of support. He watched me, everything that life threw at a guy, he was there to help me out. I'm just glad that I had a chance to meet somebody like Bill, because everyone will know that he gave you something to help you through your day. I'll miss him dearly. I'm proud as hell to know him now.
Who's next?
I'll go, Steve. My brother already spoke a little bit. You know, Bill was like my other brother. Always there with my brother Jeff. My brother Jeff was out of the country, Mormon missionary for a couple of years, and that's when I got married. So Bill was my best man. I love that guy, like another little brother. And this is so surreal for me. I was on the phone with him for probably 2 or 3 hours on Wednesday. I knew he was depressed, but I wish there would have been something. Whenever I call you, I'm always concerned about it, no matter what it is. Anyway, he was truly one of the best people I have ever known.